Hello everyone. In this video, given is a right triangle ABC. A circle is given in such a way that the side AB of this right triangle is the diameter of the circle. The circle crosses the side AC at some point. This, let we call this point P, and a tangent is drawn from point P, which intersect the line BC at some point Q. By this limited data, we have to prove that the length BQ is equal to QC. Means this tangential line divides BC into two equal parts. Keep in mind, figure may not be 100% true to the scale. Let we move towards the solution. First of all, we draw a line segment from point P to B, which is perpendicular to the line AC. This angle APB is of 90 degrees, and in the same manner the angle BPC is of 90 degrees. Now let we call the angle BPQ as alpha and QPC as beta. Then it is very much clear that alpha plus beta angle is equal to 90 degrees. Now we have a circle theorem. If we have a point outside the circle and two tangents are drawn from that point to the circle, then the length of these tangents is always equal. So here Q is the exterior point, and we have drawn two tangents that are QP and QB. So the lengths QP and QB are same. Now let we consider this triangle. Since two sides of this triangle are equal, therefore it is an isosceles triangle, and thus it two angles must be equal. If the angle at point B is gamma, then angle alpha must be equal to angle gamma. Now let we call the angle at point C is theta, and we consider this larger triangle, that is BPC. From this triangle, since angle at point P is of 90 degrees, so the sum of other two angles must be equal to 90 degrees. So angle gamma plus angle theta, that must be equal to 90 degrees. Since from this equation angle alpha plus angle beta is 90 degrees, and from this equation angle gamma plus angle theta is equal to 90 degrees, so by comparing these two equations, we will find out angle alpha plus angle beta, that is equal to angle gamma plus angle theta. From this equation, we have angle alpha is equal to angle gamma. Replacing this value over here, and from here, angle gamma on left and right will be cancelled out, and thus angle beta will be equal to angle theta. Now by this triangle, this green triangle, we have two sides equal, because this is isosceles triangle. So PQ, that is equal to QC side. Since PQ is equal to QB from this equation, and PQ is equal to QC, we know that if A is equal to B and B is equal to C, then A is equal to C. So from here we can write QB is equal to QC. And that is the answer. If you found this video helpful, then please subscribe my channel and give a thumbs up to the video. Thank you for watching.